developmental therapeutics, especially in children, has changed dramatically in the last 10 years. We are now bringing new agents to children more quickly than we have in the past, and more children are receiving new agents than ever before.
If you believe that you have a patient at high risk for recurrence, if you have a patient whose disease you're not controlling well, measuring, for instance, minimal residual disease and it's not going down quickly enough, or if you have a patient who's just relapsed, what I would say is contact us early. We will work with you. We will let you know if we do have any treatment options for your patients, either at that moment in time or at a later point.
You don't want to wait until a child has been hospitalized for a long period with multiple infections, maybe having kidney or liver problems from all the combined chemotherapy they've received. Those kind of things are what keeps a child from getting experimental therapy.
The key here, the intent, is to preserve the option for as many treatment possibilities for any given patient as we can. And the earlier we hear about it, the more we can advise the referring physician about what may or may not be available.
What we try to do is gather as much information about the child and about their relapse cancer as possible. And we do that so that we can try to find treatments that will target the cause of the relapse, and to try to, as much as we can, individualize or tailor the therapy for an individual child and his or her circumstances.
CART19 is the first example of engineering cells to attack cancer that we feel actually has, in very, very early results, shown some real ability to remove large amounts of disease and to put patients with no other therapeutic options into remission. So the essential nature of the CART19 treatment is that we have to get T cells from the patient. We can engineer these cells so that they basically restore the ability of these cells to go after cancer cells and kill them. In order to make these cells, we have to have access to these cells. And so it is absolutely the case that if it is clear that you have a patient for whom there is a high likelihood of the disease returning, or the disease has just returned, that if you treat that patient with intensive chemotherapy multiple times, and then at that point say maybe it would be appropriate to consider cell therapy in that patient, what we're learning is that at that point you also don't have any T cells to be able to manufacture. So I think the real change in thinking and our challenge in educating folks and our own learning on this is really about the fact that you have to think of collecting the cells in advance. You have to think of it in order. You have to think of the collection of the cells first, and then you have to think about giving chemotherapy second.
When a patient or their physician contacts us, we really want to discuss all the options. We want to educate their oncologist as well, so that the oncologist can also talk with the family. That doctor is somebody who has to be on board with this next step, this experimental therapy. We need to have a good working relationship with the entire team to get the child the best therapy possible.
So I think the idea is that we hear early about patients who have either recurrent or high-risk disease. We have enter into a dialogue of what might or might not be appropriate. We see the patient in second opinion here if that's something that actually makes sense for the family and what the referring doc actually wants to do. And then if we do need to collect cells for potential cell therapy, we get that done quickly. And then we let the patient go back to their treating physician for any appropriate chemotherapy, and then bring them back for any potential experimental therapy that might benefit that patient. So it's really an attempt to work in tandem with the referring physician, do those things that the patient can do at their referring institutions, and really limit our role to the things where we really have that available here but nowhere else.